Hello everyone and welcome back to my channel, or if you're new here, welcome for the first time. Today I'm going to share with you one of my favorite things that my mom used to make for us growing up, and that is tacos dorados de papa, or how most people know them, flautas. They are so simple to make, they're so delicious, the filling is just magical to me. I used to steal spoonfuls of it when my mom would turn her back to fry the tacos. This is a super budget-friendly meal, and it is a great dinner idea. I hope that you give it a try and stay tuned till the end because I'm going to show you how I made the green salsa. I'm going to get started with some Yukon Gold potatoes, which are my favorite, but I'm sure any potato will work just fine. I'm going to quarter them, and then I'm also going to cut off the little ugly parts. And I'm using 4, and that's going to yield us about 2 dozen tacos. You can definitely peel them beforehand, but I'm just going to peel them when they're done cooking because I hate using the potato peeler. But I'm going to throw them into a pot of water. You want to make sure that your water is cold or room temperature. You do not want to boil your water before you add your potatoes because then your potatoes will cook unevenly. Add a generous amount of salt and boil them until they're done cooking, and you'll know they're done when you poke them with a fork and the fork just goes in there like if it was going into some butter. And so here I'm just going to risk burning off my fingertips to peel off the skin because I am impatient and I couldn't wait until they cooled off. But like I said, you can always peel them beforehand if you don't want to do this step. Then I'm going to generously season with some salt. Potatoes need a lot of salt, okay? I added about 1.5 to 2 teaspoons. I don't usually measure, but I measured it for this time so you guys have kind of an idea of how much salt I add. And then I'm gonna crack a lot of fresh black pepper on top. I think black pepper is my favorite seasoning. I don't know, but it is. And then I'm gonna add 1/2 cup of shredded cheese and an egg. Yes, an egg. The egg just makes the potatoes so creamy, so delicious. And I added the egg on purpose when the potatoes are still a little bit hot so that it kind of is a little bit cooked with the steam of the potatoes. You know, it's not like scrambled eggs, but it's not like super raw salmonella vibes. Mash up your potatoes until you have your desired consistency. You can leave them a little chunky or as smooth as you want. I like mine with still a little bit of whole pieces of potato in there. And then the next steps are just super easy. I'm going to heat up some tortillas in the microwave between 2 damp paper towels. I do them in the microwave because I want them to get soft and pliable without getting hard like they would if you heated them up on your comal. I'm just gonna put a generous amount of potato inside and then just roll them up into these little tacos. Did you guys know that there is a front and a back side to every tortilla, and the back side is supposed to go on the inside of your taco? I kind of still get confused identifying which is which because sometimes they just look the same to me, but the back side is the side with the lines a little bit more pronounced. So anyway, once we have our taco tower all built, I'm going to heat up some oil. You could have done this before you started making your tacos, but I just didn't want it to burn. So I'm going to heat up the oil, and then we're just going to add our tacos in there in a little row. And then we're going to cook them for about 1 to 2 minutes on each side. It depends on how hot your oil is, but this can go pretty fast. So do not walk away because you will burn them or they'll just be super, super toasty. Anyway, cook them on each side for about 1 to 2 minutes and then just take them out. I like to put them into this colander that I lined with paper towels so that they can just soak up a little bit of the grease off these tacos. And yeah, we're gonna repeat this step for every single one of our tacos. And then I'm going to shred up some lettuce. I like to use iceberg lettuce for this, but I sometimes use cabbage. Cabbage is really good on these as well. You can use whatever you have, whatever you like. And then here, I'm just gonna show you really quickly how I made this green salsa that I used on this day. I took jalapenos, serranos, onions, and then fried them in a good amount of oil. And the oil is going to help this salsa be creamy, and it's gonna make it look like you put some avocado in there, but you didn't. So once the peppers and stuff have cooled off, I'm gonna put them in my blender and then add a garlic and then add some cilantro with the stems and all. And then some chicken nor for some flavor. And then I started blending in and I thought it was a little bit too thick, so I added a little bit of water and then kept blending it, and this is how it turned out. This was my first time making a salsa like this, and it was pretty good. And then once we top our tacos with all of our lettuce and sour cream and salsa and queso fresco, we have this delicious, delicious meal. Tell me in the comments below if you are a flauta lover and what other fillings you would like to see me make them with. Thank you so much for watching this video. If you liked it, please give it a thumbs up and don't forget to subscribe before you leave, and I will see you next time.